Andrew, as you consolidate a place in the finals, you must be looking forward to it. Does training change from now on?
It does change a little bit with the heavier tracks and all that sort of stuff. So we've got to limit the guys as far as leg power is concerned. But it's important that we win today's game against South, and then we can set ourselves up with three home games and put pressure on these top three sides.
Last week we went down to Glenelg and we got a bit of a building down there, and then come off and didn't get any hot showers down there. And I can promise the Eagles this week that if we give them a flogging, they'll at least have hot showers.
Adelaide Oval, last season's Wooden Spooners, South Adelaide's Panthers take the field against their semi-final conquerors and 1963 premiers, Port Adelaide. The Magpies snatched a one-point victory in the semi, and the second biggest crowd in South Australia's football history, over 56,000, are hoping for another thriller. In their clashes this season, Port have a 2-1 winning margin, but the Panthers are playing on their home ground today, and Backman snaps their first goal after 10 minutes play. White sends South away again. Taking a great mark in the pack, Darley is within goal-kicking range. Making no mistake, Darley kicks through the centre, and Curley's kids have a 13-point lead. Matching the Magpies in every department, the Panthers are giving their all under captain coach Neil Curley, who was brought across from the West this season. From a throw-in, the Panthers spring into the attack again. Sharking behind the pack, Ross gets a long kick away and Day dribbles it through for South's fourth goal. Smith gives the flying Skews a chance and he's away. His kick finds Jackson, who beats Illaway to the mark. The Panthers are full of confidence and are driving home every advantage. Jackson gives South their fifth goal and they lead by 26 points at half-time. The scoreboard telling the story of Port's lost opportunities. No goals, 10 behinds. South's teamwork is at its peak and White takes a splendid mark as the Panthers are poised to increase their lead. It's only 70 seconds into the third quarter and White, with a perfect kick, scores his second goal of the match. Port came from seven goals down to defeat South in the semi-final, and they need another big effort today to save the flag. Jeff Potter puts them in a good position, and after 57 minutes play, Freeman snaps their first goal. Gaining possession, Gill, one of Port's five big men, sends to Philp. Philp passes to Freeman, and he's awarded a free. ...19-year-old Freeman kicks strongly as Port, heartened by their goal, are lifting their game. With intelligent sharking, Potter snaps another goal and the Premier's combination appears at last to be moving into top gear. Philp thumps the ball goalwards and Freeman takes one of the best marks of the day. Freeman, the Magpies' youngest player, has already figured prominently in Port's two goals and is set to kick their third. It's there and the Magpies are back in the fight. Potter kicks long and straight with 2 minutes of the quarter remaining and finds the centre for the Magpies' fourth goal. They're 16 points down at three-quarter time and appear to be coming on strongly. The final quarter. Hannaford again wins the ruck, but the Panthers' pace gives them the edge. The big boy from Darwin, David Cantilla, is on the spot again and is judged by the majority as the best player on the field. His long kick rolls through for a behind. But Porter outsped by South. Skuse takes a good mark against taller opposition. Skuse kicks his first goal and the Panthers go to a 19-point lead and victory is in sight. Ian Day has a great opportunity of sealing the flag for South. His kick is through the centre in a great moment for Daisy, who now goes into retirement as South win the premiership, 9 goals, 15 to Port's 5-12.
Well, good afternoon to you and welcome to Noarlunga Oval for round 15 and our look at the game between South Adelaide and the Eagles this afternoon. Our other game is between Sturt and North at Prospect. And we'll be heading up there in just a moment. You just saw the 1964 Grand Final. I should tell you it wasn't live. You're watching a replay from 32 years ago. And we thought that we'd just give the Panthers a little bit of solace. It's been tough over the last few weeks. You heard Shane Butler at the top of the show saying that they had cold showers. Well, they've also lost their past 7 games. They've had a wretched season. They're sitting at the bottom. So we thought we might take you back 32 years and just show that South Adelaide still can, or did at least, produce some goods. And today, they're doing pretty well against the Eagles. And speaking of the Eagles, sitting alongside me this afternoon is veteran and now retired veteran, Andrew Taylor. Good afternoon to you.
Good afternoon, Stephen.
Now, retirement, why is this? Why have you done it today?
It was one of those issues. The old body was starting to play up. I was having a lot of
trouble. It happens, it happens.
It does, yes. And it was just one of those problems that I couldn't overcome. I'm having a lot of troubles with Achilles, and if I don't think if I did anything now about it, I'd have trouble.
So we just see Andrew's stats there, 149 games, a state game in there, and with Footscray a game as well. The time at the Bears would have been interesting for you?
Yes, it's as a former player now, I look at the way they're going and I'm wrapped for the club. With the new merger happening, it's a good situation for the club and it was good to be part of it in the early days.
What about the Eagles this year? It's been an up and down season for them. In fact, at one stage I remember commenting through the year that they're up and down, one up, one down. It's just been one of those seasons for them.
Yeah, we're quite patchy. We had a lot of players who come from all over Australia to recruit, so the players are now just starting to get it together.
We spoke about South Adelaide and the wretched season that they're having. Shane Butler took over just prior to round 7 when Ken Sheldon departed, and through no fault of his own, I can guarantee it, it's a tough gig when you pick up a team halfway through the year. They won the next game in round 7 and they beat North Adelaide. Since, they've lost every single game, and Shane Butler's had a very, very difficult time, as you'll get from the mood of this interview with him.
We, because of our fade-outs we've had in the second half of games, we decided to train early. Went down the beach for a run and basically had a chat with the players. And, you know, they had some ideas for the next couple of weeks to improve our second half performances. Well, it's not a real, physical thing. We think it's more mental. You know, they get to a certain stage and, you know, the game's there to be won or lost. And I think we're trying to hang on rather than, you know, surging forward, and I think as soon as we can overcome that, we'll have a few more wins. Well, I think the players have really, you know, come to terms with the fact that, you know, they haven't been putting the performances in every Saturday, and that something has to be done. You know, all the excuses have been made for us over the early part of the season, and now it's time to, you know, just get down to footy basics and, you know, get back into the winning vein. Yeah, well, the home ground advantage hasn't worked so far. I mean, it's been disappointing, but I think it's going to get like it is down at Elizabeth. You know, everyone used to hate driving out to Elizabeth. Well, now people have to come up the hill to Noarlunga to play us in a very windy atmosphere. We get a lot of rain up there. And hopefully, you know, over the coming seasons, it's going to be very difficult for sides to come up and play us at home.
Shane Butler has his hands full, as I said. They won the next one against North Adelaide, and since, it's been a very tough time.
Yeah, they've had to work very hard for it. A lot of people do forget, though. They lost a lot of players at the start of the
That's
year,
right.
Quality players. So as a club, they're rebuilding and so forth. And yes, the last few weeks have been slow, but, you know, they'll get back there.
Now, your captain, Andrew Rogers, has been at Essendon. He's been at Geelong. He's had a wonderful career, as you see at the bottom there, those AFL games at Woodville and the Eagles. He's racked up 147, including this year's state captain. His on-field leadership, Andrew, must be excellent.
Look, his record does speak for itself. He's been a quality player for a lot of years now, a guy from Perry. He's been fantastic, and he's still playing good football today.
And he's a bit of a character. We spoke to him yesterday.
Andrew, the last 3 weeks have been terrific for the Eagles, 3 wins in a row. It started with Port Adelaide. You've really turned the season around for the club.
Yeah, we know we had a couple of meetings and we decided that we needed to do something. We weren't just happy rolling along and being down the bottom side. So we had a couple of meetings and with the players we decided this wasn't the way we wanted to go for the year. So we decided to have a crack at it.
To outside observers, there's been a bit of a discipline broom or a broom sweeping through the club. You've lost a few players. Stuart Todham's one who's quit the club. Andrew Taylor's resigned. Is there a movement within the club just to strengthen and tidy up?
Oh, I don't think so. I think it's just what we've really said is we want players there that really want to be involved and really want to play footy for the club. You know, Stewie Totham was one that didn't want to play footy for the club. Andrew Taylor, unfortunately, is succumbing to injury. So, you know, that's a bit out of our control. But, yeah, certainly we've wanted players that have wanted to be there for the right reasons.
Most notably the last few weeks, your attack on the man with the ball, your desperation has been quite fantastic, and you've got back to almost like that form of 1993 where you've really beaten sides to death.
Yeah, I think that comes with just a passion for your footy. I think that, as you improve, you get more confident, and that's one of your part of your games that picks up where in the previous weeks before those 3 weeks, we sort of struggled in that area. I think with more confidence and with more passion for the game, we've improved.
Andrew Rogers there with David Mackay just yesterday, and DB's down on the boundary line. David, we looked at the 1964 grand final just a little earlier in the day, a big day for South Adelaide. Where were you in 64?
64, I was 7 years old, Stephen.
I beg your pardon?
I was 7 years old. And actually, you think back to that, Neil Curley, I think very few people have taken, I think he's the only one who's ever taken a side from bottom to top, did that pretty well. Won a premiership in his first year. I think Bruce Winter is one who's done that. Ian Day was roving and Lindsay Backman was in the centre. I'm just giving a bit of nostalgia for the South Adelaide fans who really haven't had much to cheer about this year, but that was a great year. Incidentally, down here on the boundary line, I can just look across to the Norlunga Reef and I can see a couple of humpback whales swimming in the reef, Triggy, so perhaps we might get the flippers on after the match.
There's a couple of lines there. I'll leave it alone, David. Speaking about sides who may go top with their first-year coach, Central District might do it. They're sitting on top of the premiership table at the moment. And Andrew, Central, Port and Norwood seem to be making a break, don't they?
Yeah, a few weeks ago you would have thought that those top three would break right away, but the Eagles certainly have come back into intention. If they win today, and obviously when Norwood and Port play, someone's got to lose that, so they can get back around the two on the same points there. Westies aren't that far off the mark and over the bay, so it is still fairly close from second through to about fifth or sixth.
Good dice going for fifth spot and fourth and fifth, in fact, but certainly the top three seemingly making a break. Hodges, now as a full forward, he sits on the top of the leading goal kickers at the moment. You would, I'm sure, have enormous respect for his ability up the front.
Look, Scotty's been terrific over the years to come back from the injuries that he had last year and to be kicking that amount of goals. Probably says he should have been playing at the Crows a little bit more than he is, but fantastic goal, and he makes every kick as count.
And David Mackay, I'm not surprised that Scotty's sitting up the top there. He is a class act. A broken leg, of course, round one last year. His comeback's been pretty good.
It's been terrific, Triggy, and you just wonder why the Crows perhaps have felt that they're not going to persevere with him. They still lack a little bit of firepower. I wonder why they'd recruit him, play him in two games and then drop him. It does a dreadful thing to your confidence. I wonder whether Scotty mightn't be better off to quit the club, go back to Port Adelaide, and if his contract's void with the Crows, whether or not he wouldn't be eligible to be one of the 29 players picked up from the SANFL by Port Power. And I just wonder, that's just me surmising, whether that mightn't be flashing through his brain about now.
Sounds to me pretty much like you might know the answer to that, by the way. Let's have a look at the scoreboard now then between South Adelaide and the Eagles at half-time at Norlunga. It's a pretty good battle. 41 plays 57, 16 points in it. And it's been in fits and starts, Andrew. Both sides have been pushing and shoving, and I guess it's a bit of a thrust and parry affair, but kicking it in sort of twos and threes each, and then the opposition will get a run on themselves.
Yeah, there was probably a few times where the Eagles looked as though they were going to get away from the game and take control of it, but to South's credit, they hit back every time and really came back with that one or two goals that kept them right in there. So they're still in there at the moment. I still expect a real good contest. Both sides have been hard at the ball. Both sides have crumbed very well, as you see there, so it's a very good game.
David, as our viewers will pick up, there's a fairly hefty breeze blowing from right to left across the screen, as you'll see on the faces of the commentators as well. In fact, if people stick with us, David, they might even see some snow.
No, I don't think there'll be snow here today, but clearly this breeze down at ground level, Stephen, is blowing up now, and I suspect that the Eagles will have probably what is a 3 or 4 goal advantage in the third term, but South Adelaide will come home with it in the final term if they can be close.
How have you seen this young fellow with his first kick in league footy, David?
He's a terrific find. He looks to have some pretty good skills. He almost had a chance to kick it with his second in league company. But I like the way this kid moves, and he reminds me a lot of a right-footed Osborne.
And Andrew Taylor's been terrific.
Yes, he's having a good battle when he's roving on the ball there with Jason Ziller, who started off very well and fell out of the game a little bit, but again, proving that he is a quality player.
Jason Spear's been excellent as well. And between the big blokes at South Adelaide, Steckel, McIntyre and Lade, they've worked them through the forward area. That was Ugrinic getting one just before half-time, and it was an important kick.
Yeah, it certainly was. The three big South boys that you spoke about, why they haven't dominated any part of the game, they've all been a valuable contribution by each one. From various times, they've stood up and done the things that the side needed.
And look at that for a goal from Brenton Lade. You'll see that a few times, I reckon. He took an attempt at it in the air, came to ground and then kicked, as you'll see, one of those goals. A string of singles. Morfitt and Ugrinic have a couple, David, but it's been pretty evenly spread.
I think the thing about it, there's no one player that's really torn this match apart. And even though South trail at half-time, Stephen, I think they're really in the game. We looked at them last week against Glenelg. They were pitiful. Today, they've been very, very competitive. They could still win this match.
Needless to say, they'll need to start that third quarter in grand style. Down at Football Park, first plays sixth, Central are on top. They're playing Glenelg, who are just outside but knocking on the door of the final five. That's a quarter-time score. The game started a bit later. And if you're a Central fan, I think you'd be pretty pleased with that. 6-4 to one behind. Tomorrow, Port Adelaide play Norwood. And that, David, to me, has a certain amount of nostalgia to it. Over 100 years of great tradition between the two. And for the last time, they'll slug it out on a suburban ground.
I thought your article this morning, Stephen, was quite appropriate. They've had a couple of deaths in the side. There's been a lot of emotion played between these two sides. And I think it'll be a big match with a big crowd tomorrow.
Yes, no telecast of that, but we look forward to seeing the result. The other game, of course, this afternoon is at Prospect Oval. And we say good afternoon to Mark Nailey and Alan Stewart. How are you, boys?
Cold.
I don't understand that. It's nice and warm down here. Tell us a little bit about your game. You've got North Adelaide playing Sturt. Sturt are off the bottom. How are they travelling?
Well, they've played very well so far, Stephen. It's been a very competitive game. It's evenly poised. And you can see by the score there that North have a one-goal margin over Sturt. And it's come about because Glenn Sanford was very strong and aggressive at centre-half forward for North Adelaide in that second term.
Nails, have we seen anything of Kim Klomp? Did he turn up and play?
Yes, he did. He came on about the second quarter. He did a warm-up in front of the old members stand and they booed and jeered him. But he just looked up and smiled and just waved to them all. But he is a character. But you can see the highlights here. I mean, it's been a very good stand-up game. Sturt have really have thrown everything at North Adelaide today. They were leading there by about 12, a little bit about 12 points in the second quarter. But you can see a young man seeing. He's been very, very busy today, along with Franco. A good work here by Franco. He goes back and kicks a goal. But some good work by North Adelaide. They just seem to be a little bit too big, don't they?
Very
today,
strong,
Alan.
Particularly at centre-half forward. Sanford's played the best game of football I've seen him play in the South Australian competition. And he's been very, very aggressive. On screen, we saw Bruce Lennon a minute ago, and he's been very effective for Sturt.
Young Weatherall here, he kicked his first goal.
Yes.
Which was good, but Sturt really have a lot of pressure on that North. I think North just seem to be playing on every occasion, don't they?
Sturt, to my way of thinking, don't run the ball well enough from centre-half forward, from the half-back line to centre-half forward, but they are a very aggressive and hard-tackling side.
See the goal kickers there about the half time. Sanford's kicked a couple, as you mentioned before, he's been in everything. And for Sturt, they've had Weatherall, Ops, Lemon, and Hall who have kicked singles here today.
Okay, thank you very much, boys. How do you see the second half, Stewie?
I think it'll go as it's been all day, very even, very tight, and only a small margin at the end.
Always seems, of course, when Sturt need to get out of trouble, they have a losing sequence, to me at least, even without looking back at statistics, they always seem to knock over West Adelaide or North Adelaide.
It's funny how you do that as a club. There's always one or two sides you get the wood on, and
sure.
They seem to be the ones for Sturt.
Yes, indeed. Of course, stay with us throughout the afternoon. We'll have a look at the second half down here at Noarlunga. And the last time that these two sides met was in round six at Woodville Oval. South Adelaide gave it their best shot, but they went down by 32 points, having had a terrific first half. But the Eagles overpowered them. Now, that's very important for South Adelaide today, that if they're going to get off the bottom, and Sturt, of course, are threatening out at Prospect Oval, if they go two games down, they'll be in a lot of strife. Here's their win-loss record for the Panthers. A win over Sturt in round one, a win over North Adelaide in round seven, and other than byes where you see the bees there, there are a whole lot of losses. For the Eagles, as I said earlier with Andrew Taylor, a win and a loss and a win and a loss all the way through But this today, if they can get it, being 16 points up at half-time, will give them four in a row and a great fillip for the second half of the season. To see us through the second half and the start of the third quarter, here's David Mackay.
Thanks, Triggy. 16 points the margin at Noarlunga, where the Panthers have played four this year and have only won one, so they haven't got a great home record. And we've just had a radio report from Melbourne too. If you're listening and you're a football fan, we believe that Andrew Jarman has resigned from the Crows. A radio report fresh in. Bad news for the Crows. Worst news, I suspect, for Andrew Jarman, if it's true, in fact. Laid thumps it forward. Steckel, who's played a great game rucking in across half forward today, pushes it wide. Christensen, the back door to Rogers, handballs forward into space. Bailey just muffed it, the opportunity. Andrew Osborne back now to Whitman. A high ball to half forward, and under it, a plucky little player in Pearce in the back pocket for the Eagles. Now it's Devine distributing it wide. Ziller and Paige didn't quite work that out. I thought Ziller could have had a run at it, but Paige was there. And in the finish, it's thumped across the line and out of play. John Polkinghorne, best and fairest for the Panthers. Now, there is one best and fairest for the Panthers sitting in the Eagles' bunker, by the way. Marty Dillon, who played here a couple of years ago, won it 3 years ago. And there's Bruce Winder in the bunker. I'm not sure that he'd be all that content where his players are at the moment. 16 points ahead of South Adelaide. 1.5 minutes into the third time, I think he would have been looking for a bigger lead than that. This is Bailey, flicking it out to Pesh. Oh, well stolen by Andrew Osborne. The runner is Whitman. They're lifting South Adelaide. They're playing with some great form today after a thrashing last week. Laid off the ground, goes forward. Spear, who had a cracking game in the first half, gets the kick away. It was fortunate, and it lands with Pearce deep in the back pocket.
Adam Pearce has a look out and finds Nick Pesh. Pesh has a spare one on the far side. It's Hall. Takes and breaks and has a bounce on centre wing. Nice little burst of sunshine as he gets the ball to half forward. Kluzek is hustled and bustled across the line, Andrew. And Kluzek, how have you seen his game?
I don't think he's really been in the play a lot today. That's one of those situations Matthew just did there. Kluzek just needs to grab hold of that ball. He needs him just to be stronger and more set in his mind that he's going to take that mark.
Perhaps the Crows need a specialist goal sneak if Andrew Jarman, in fact, is not there.
Why on earth would he resign? We'll get to that shortly, Baddams. And we'll get some comment from a couple of my colleagues throughout the afternoon as Whitman to Osborne. Osborne, are you caught, Ozzie? Nowhere to go, caught cold, holding the footy. Good tackle.
Yeah, he's pretty mobile, big Doug Bailey. Osborne on the run, usually a bloke will get around you there, but that was a very good tackle.
Comments Andrew Osborne, former Eagle full forward, as Bailey goes through the half-forward line. Andrew Taylor, sorry. We're forgetting about you already, Andrew.
Pesh. That's easily done.
Yes. Wide. This kick was smothered. This is Merton. On the left boot, around the corner he goes to space. Safety first, but it went out of bounds. And that breeze is obviously a factor, Andrew.
Yeah, again, a league player shouldn't miss a kick like that unless a breeze is really tricky out there.
So they punch it up there again. Filippo, it's spoiled away by Steckel. Off hands. The handball's okay. South Adelaide are under some heat back there. Oh, good little pickup by Baddams. Just inside the boundary line. The breeze freshen. Well, it does freshen throughout the afternoon down here. And certainly picked up since the start of this game. So if South Adelaide can hold some ground during this third term, they might be well placed in the last quarter. Well done, McIntyre. Handled it cleanly. Now let's do something nice and positive, South Adelaide. Cameron, good work, and finds, oh, the player looking into the sunshine. Almost looked as though he was trying to catch an invisible ball. Christensen gets it across the top and away they go.
And it was unfortunate for Johnson. He had no idea where that ball was. It was just dead in the line of the sun. Browning, who started on the bench, came on and kicked a goal into the open goal in the second term. Mills, Merton to space. And that ball will just sit just inside the line, or no, it'll just go out. So it was a well-weighted kick in the finish and across the line.
Yeah, clever little click. He looked up the ground. There wasn't anything going on, so he just pushed it over the boundary line.
Steckel goes into battle with Bailey, and Bailey's held his ground pretty well. I can't recall him being rested so far with Neiman up the front. And he's had to contend with Steckel, McIntyre and Laid. There's a fair bit of height amongst that threesome. Here he is holding his ground. Steckel wins the tap. The Panthers work it away with some numbers. The short pass is okay, but Osborne, that's Greg Osborne, can't control it. Goes across the line. Just a score check. 8-9 to 6-5. Still the 16 points that was in it at halftime.
Young Greg Osborne on screen. First game. You've just joined us. He kicked a goal with his first kicking lead football to join an elite band of footballers who have done that. This is Whitman over the top of it, bustled over by Browning. And again, there'll be a throw in.
I tend to think that the Eagles might be tagging Whitman right at the moment with young Nigel Browning, who's still relatively inexperienced player.
Yes, Whitman, former Hawthorn player, had a year at Southport after being a great player two seasons ago with the Panthers. He's been very solid in the first half and a driving force behind South Adelaide being so close to the Eagles. Now, Ugrinic and Webb. McLaurin Webb, correction. Just have a little bustle off the ball. Pesh, out of bounds on the full.
Unfortunate, it's one of those quick kicks out of the back that don't always get where you want to go, but he's starting to get into the game now, Pesh.
It's all pretty static for the Panthers. Laid off as something. He's got the longest arms. Oh. They're very long, aren't they? It's a good mark, though, because there's a bit of pressure there. And Lade's kick now. Holds up in the breeze. Speaking of long arms, McIntyre is there. Can't quite take it. But as it bounces out, it gives Knight a chance. And he poked at it and made a mess of it. Absolutely butchered it. Morfitt. Maybe touch to give him the benefit of the doubt to Bailey. Bailey plays it on to Hall. Just an average piece of work, but the Hall handball was excellent. And finally, the ball finishes up with Filippo at half forward. Sam's just staging that a little bit. Hands off. Nice and easy, finds Zilla. And Zilla, a couple of Panthers down there. Pays, poked it out. Panthers have the numbers, and Whitman gets it.
Clears it to Andrew Osborne. A rover deep in the defensive zone. Long ball to Steckel. He's played a cracking game today. He's been a real leader for South Adelaide. His fellow Knight's been solid and hard at it, but the kick was wayward. Rogers pushed off the ball, 25-minute penalty. Noticed at the umpire. This is where the Eagles have let themselves down, by the way. Their game is playing on at all costs.
Yeah, Eagles trying to get run out of their back line, so they do take some risk.
The last few moments, they just haven't got anything. Filippo held it up, as he's done there. Now, he's had two or three options. Now he decides to play on with it. They need to be a lot quicker moving the ball forward, the Eagles, and that's a better movement. Quickly in one-on-one, Draper couldn't compete with Neiman, and Neiman marks.
He's a big, big, strong boy, and in these situations, one-on-one is what the Eagles are trying to get. They're trying to get him in that goal square, one-on-one, to take those balls, if not bring him to the front. And good play by Sam Filippo, who's starting to get into it, as we've mentioned. And it's allowed the blokes like Filippo to get right in the game.
So David Neiman, who started as a 16-year-old, his league career, I think his debut game was 5 goals. He's kicked 179 career goals. Make this 180 if he kicks it through. And it's only a point. What about David Neiman missing there?
David Neiman. Neiman, very good player. Probably should be plenty playing AFL footy. He's very important for us in his golf at the goal front sort of thing. Big fella, he's strong, and one day he's just going to take the game by the scruff of the neck, I reckon.
Andrew Rogers has played a very good game himself, and that's not a bad take either on the far side. Ugrinic thumps it up, falls into the arms of Bailey, and Bailey plays it on left leg. Kluzek. That's a higher ball than it is long. Some pressure on down there for number 49 for South Adelaide. He's really under some heat as Duncan Draper. Kluzek again. I'm not sure what he's trying to do, Matthew, because he's kicking the ball higher than longer on two occasions.
A couple of other games around the country. North over Sturt by 16 points. North Adelaide really need the win to get back in contention for the five. Central by 32 points over Glenelg. Glenelg, after being so good last week against South, disappointing today.
Here at Noarlunga, Neiman. It'd be pretty good from there. Oh, it's just that. Neiman gets his second, and the Eagles go a little further ahead. At the 9.5, nearly 10-minute mark of this third quarter, the Eagles are 9-10 and South Adelaide are 6-5.
Again, the big fella showing his versatility to pick the ball off the ground. Morfitt does well to keep it in play there. he's able to swing it on, throw it on the left foot and put it through for a very good goal.
Well, there it is for Bruce Winter. Played 12 and won 7. They started shakily and they've won their last three, sitting in fourth position on the ladder and challenging for the finals.
Lade. Crunch time for South Adelaide. Lade gets it out. Baddams has the leg speed, but he's up against Ugrinic, who, even working into the breeze with that great pace of his, sees it to the line.
And Andrew, that's been a great battle with Ugrinic and Baddams. Well matched today.
Yep, they're both very quick over the ground. They're both not big, strong players yet, but it's been a good contest.
McIntyre in ruck against Bailey. It's been McIntyre, Lade and Steckel against Bailey today, and they've really had a go at the Big Eagle ruckman. David Neiman's been sitting at full forward. And there's been a theory too, Andrew, you might be able to help us. When Bailey's gone out of the ruck during the third quarter, the Eagles have had a fade-out. Today, Bruce Winter's kept him in ruck.
Yeah, it has happened over the last 3 or 4 weeks where he'll make the change and put Bailey to full forward and Neiman on the ball, and it has corresponded every time.
Now, excuse me, Andrew, but I think this is a deliberate free kick. There's a real square-up going on here. Boom. They wrestled off the ground about a minute and a half ago, and I think Bailey thought he came off second best.
I think Bailey thought that the thing that he got hold of was the red ball. Correctly. This is Pierce. He's got Zilla, and Godzilla kicks it short, finds Filippo. Good little pass. Just backward of centre wing, hands it off. He's done that so very well today to Nick Pesch. And Pesch was under some pressure with a player coming at him. Still got the kick away. They've got some space down there. Mills works it back. Trent Mills around the body. Kluzek puts the pressure on, and as you said, he and Baddams having a fine duel.
Cleans up very well down there, Trent Mills. He's a player that's quite stable and is somebody that they can really start to build a good back line out to him leading down there.
McIntyre opposed to Sam Filippo. McIntyre takes front position, pushes it to the defensive side, but Ugrinic is quick enough and lightning quick enough, by the way. Pick it up, drive it towards Neiman, who charged out a good commitment. Over the top of the ball, Webb strongly thumps the boot to the ball and goes straight to the line.
Done well again there, Webb, to bring that ball out. I think he's had a very good game thus far.
Noarlunga Oval in tremendous condition for all the rain that we've had. Ball's bouncing truly. Azilla's tackled. What's the verdict there? That's a bit tough. Too high.
Now you called him Godzilla before. When did Azilla become a Godzilla?
Well, I think that's what his teammates call him.
No, his teammates don't call him. The general public call him that.
Spoiled forward. South Adelaide now need to repel this little bit of movement and bounce it back up to their end so they can get a score going. Baddams again did okay. In fact, he did very well. To Harris, who's been quiet. Missed the target completely to Polkinghorne. And Polkinghorne's kick is half smothered. He'll still find the mark, though. Greg Osborne. Around in circles. Probably should have kept going straight on. Didn't he make a mess of that?
Skill errors, skill errors, skill errors. Every time you turn it over, you give the opportunity, the opposition to have a very good crack at you. And the Eagles bring the ball into their forward line.
You're not a commentator. Andrew, leave that to me, will you?
Sorry.
This is Harris. Played a great first quarter, by the way, but I agree with you, Stephen. He's drifted out of the game since then. McClure handballs over the head to Bailey. Feeds off to Spear, who's played a cracker. The kick was smothered. Now it's Bailey again. Butters up. Well smothered Whitman. Good work of Adams. Now Harris gets through traffic, dispatches it forward. Now Steckel will need to work to get under the contest, but Pierce just kicked it straight off the ground and did very well to push it back from where it came. Filippo's worked hard at centre-half forward. The cousins combined. Ugrinic back to Filippo. Working hard still, needs support, gets it in the form of Browning. Around the corner goes Nigel, and under it, big thump away was McIntyre. And Cameron, caught on the boundary line, just keeps it in. Brings it back. Harris. And a long ball into the breeze. Oh, Spear, great commitment. What commitment that was.
It's a very good play. He's really having a day out. And I hope he gets a good hold of the tape after the game.
Chris Whitman, a couple of magnificent smothers in the middle of the ground. His chasing and work has been excellent as Bailey gets it on the centre wing, far side. In he goes. Has Pesch. And Nicky Pesch has been okay as well. He's outside of scoring range, but he'll thump it right up to the line, I'm sure, because David Neiman is lurking down there somewhere. Philippo's also there, gets a spoil away, laid from the ground. That's always a bit dodgy because you're unsure of where it's going to finish up. They were lucky this time. It ended up with Knight to Steckel, who's also been wonderful throughout the, well, either the forward line or on the ball. Back they go. And they work it out with Matty Baddams. Now, he doesn't have a lot on offer except for one spare. It's Osborne. They expected him to go on the right leg. He goes out on the left side, takes some bounces. They want to give it back to Osborne. They did it okay. Now, will they finish off or mess around with it? One too many handballs to Cameron, who misses it. And the Eagles swoop and do it pretty well.
From defence, see, I like the way Andrew Osborne just took off and played on quickly. It just threw open the whole defensive action by the Eagles. Now Morgan works hard for it. But that, Andrew, is what I'm talking about with South Adelaide. When they play on and they go quickly and don't grandstand, they look terrific.
Yeah, it was good build-up. The South players ran the ball in there well, which you have to do on this big ground. They just one handball too many that missed.
North Adelaide have the break on Sturt. The Bulldogs a break on the Bays. Rogers really under some heat. Osborne's going to get a free kick. Which way are you pointing there? And I must be just off the footy, and Rogers is going to get it. Don't think Andrew Rogers gets a heartbeat over 100, you know, in a game of football. He's cool, calm and collected. We've been hearing from him a little throughout the afternoon as South Adelaide work it out of that defensive area. Push out, and Webb's going to get it.
Yeah, just an unfortunate way to push him straight in the back there in the marking contest.
Webb to the middle and looking into the sun but still doing okay was McIntyre. He took off, the kicks of beauty into the breeze, right up towards half forward. They really like a couple of soft takes down there, I reckon, the Panthers, to give them something really to get them going. Pays. Jumped on the footy and then took it to the far side. The Filippo just set up nicely for him. And Sam's short pass looks lovely. Right into the arms of Neiman.
Sign of a quality player that can just pick the ball up like that and shoot out a 30-metre pass straight into the leading forward.
Didn't go above a metre and a half, did it? It just drilled him.
It's a good sign for the Eagles with Filippo playing well at that.
Yeah, he's played a solid game today.
One of those lace-out jobs. Now, David Neiman's looking into the, well, the sunshine. Has 2-2. I think he's probably got 2-3. So we're past the halfway mark of this third term, and the Eagles are 9-11, South are 6-5. Really crunch time for the old Panthers.
It is in the early game, in the early part of the year, the same setup.
No, we're 8 points adrift at half time, and really got belted by, I think, 32, 34 points as Osborne. This is Greg Osborne comes off, Christensen. Gets the feed, outside 50, goes long, it'll lob right in the square. Who wants it? McIntyre was up, double-fisted it away. Loose ball falls to Neiman on the left boot around the corner. It's a miracle snap, but it's gone across the face and through. Oh, for a touched. Touched. Behind.
You can see a difference on the kickouts here today too. South have always zoned up, and the Eagles from the first half did not zone up at all. Now I see that they've slipped in the zone under the kickout.
So what's this zone mean, Andrew? Explain that to us, if you would.
Well, rather than just staying man on man with the player that you're directly on, you stand in the given area and protect that given area on a kickout.
In basketball, you'd call them posts, wouldn't you?
Yes.
Polkinghorne. Just starting to work his way back into the game. Knight is on the far side. Great-looking handball across the top to Byrne, who's just come back onto the ground. Forward it goes. It goes out the back and gives Lade a chance. Big Brenton, not that enthusiastic to get down and pick it up. Left to Steckel. Fends off and does okay. Now should hit the head of the square. The breeze holds it up. They're in the back spot, though, the worst spot. And it goes through for one behind.
Again, a good build-up by Self. They brought that ball out of the back line well. A couple of chain of handballs and then a nice kick into Steckel. And then, you know, it was good play from where he was over there.
Interesting sign for them as Devine with the ball from fullback. He's been solid today without being spectacular. He's been a good player. This fellow's battled hard, Ugrinic. Been a great battle with Baddams. Over the top of it, picking up the ball was Burnt. And if you want the tapes of these games, Andrew, you won't be interested in these now that you're not playing, but you can get them at the ABC shop or phoning 343-4601. Now, I need to know, how many did you buy during your career?
Well, I've got a heap. Don't worry about that. I've got every time I got a kick, I got a tape.
Good on you.
Umpire's found a free kick on the far side. And the Panthers will punch it back up there through Osborne. Going a bit wide. Perhaps part of the game plan in this term to just work it wide and into the breeze, try and sweat off for some time. They're four kicks in terms of goals, four clear goals behind. 24 points. If they can stay with that, they're just half a chance in the last term because the breeze will rattle them home. The Eagles, meantime, are working it out. Pushed forward by Bailey, straight into the path of a player who's half a chance now is Devine. Round the body with him, it goes to half forward. Kluzek trapped it okay. Didn't quite complete it though. Ziller required to come in and lend some support. Oh, pushed forward. The South Adelaide player was under a lot of pressure there. Whitman from the ground. Bit messy, that little piece of play. Throw it up, umpire. Let us start again.
Oh, excuse me, Stephen. Every time the ball goes into the Eagles' forward line, Andrew Taylor's jumping over the top of me, so...
Actually, it's quite interesting. Whitman seems to have just fallen out of the game a little bit. I think it's got a lot to do with that tag.
Yes, I think you're dead right there. McIntyre had the kick smothered by Marty Christensen. Browning. Ziller caught in traffic. Fends it off. McClure on the left boot around the corner. Fernie underneath it dropped it. Was pulled off the ball by Filippo. But good defensive work by the South Adelaide defenders, notably Polkinghorne. Thumps that ball towards the line and will have a throw in.
It's been quite good today, Fernie. Filippo's got away a few times, but he has been quite good in the bits and pieces that he has done.
Filippo goes into battle with McIntyre. Whitman's at the bottom. Come on, lads, let's do something clean with it. Another bounce down. It's 9-12 to 6-6. We're just into time on. Some supporters out there in the other.
That's Sam Filippo's mother and father on the outer side. Peter Filippo in the jacket. Well-known former Eagle skipper.
Yeah, quality player, accordingly. Everybody that's seen him play, unfortunately, I'm a bit too young to say it. I've seen him play, but good man to still have around the club, too.
Yeah, I enjoy you saying that, too, Andrew.
This is Whitman. And there's just absolutely nothing on offer. He can kick it if he likes along the boundary, but he'll have Bailey and Rogers. Arriving late was Byrne, who took the fly at it. He just didn't quite hold it long enough. Out of bounds.
Just seems to get himself in all the right positions, Andrew Rogers, to cut those balls off that are meant for somebody else.
Game of angles football. He plays them pretty well. Oh, great leap laid. Pesh gathers it in. A gang tackle. Byrne and Cameron. Cameron's been tough at the ball today. It's been a good day at the office for him. Marty Dillon, former South Adelaide player, sits on the bench against his old club. Club who he won the best and fairest for, too, by the way, a few years back. That's another bounce, isn't it?
This game just seems to have slowed down. Not a couple of minutes ago, I was saying the tempo went up. It just seems to have stopped straight away.
You don't mind me saying, Andrew, I think it's been a ploy of the Panthers just to slow down the Eagles and stop their scoring opportunities. And as a tactic, it's been quite terrific.
Well, the big question mark is whether they're going to be good enough to rattle home with this breeze. Where's the spark going to come from for them? We'll find out shortly. Oh, bit of a mess of that one. South Adelaide player in over the football, Ashley Fernie. And, well, look, we'll have another bounce down, shall we?
It's not been a bad tactic, Stephen, has it? Because the Eagles haven't stepped much further away. They're up by 22 points. The margin was 16 at three-quarter time. The Eagles have had the breeze.
16 at quarter time, 16 at half time. Filippo's in there. It's Sam, of course, as Ugrinic looms large. And again, they do battle. Nice little illustration of the day. Those boys have been side by side, Baddams. And this is Baddams. Back it goes to Filippo. Now they go to the boundary side. There's no percentage in that, and it gets smothered and goes across.
Yeah, it's probably a better option for Sam then would have been to pick the ball up, Sam Filippo, and kick it to the top of the square. Chose to handball it off, and Colville's kick was smothered.
As the ball comes back into play, Lade in ruck. Opposed to Sam Filippo, who's done all the ruck work. It's Lade who wins it down. Ziller steals it away, stripped of the ball. Crashing through went Scotty Morford. Couldn't get clear of the tackle. It's been a tough day at the office for Scotty today. Two goals on the board, though, and that's the value of him, isn't it? Even when it's tough, he gets a few.
Yeah, that's his role up there, just to chip him with two or three goals a game.
So high in the air, Laid again. Falls to Browning. Around the corner he goes. It'll bounce just the wrong side of the... Oh, Neiman did very well. Ricochets it back to Browning, gave him another opportunity, but he's missed to the right of the post, and it's a point.
Seems to, as every year comes on, David, Neiman gets it just a little bit wiser and a bit football smarter, if there's such a term, just to do those little things that create opportunities for other players in the club.
Harris to bring it back. He He goes to the far side. I don't think there's any doubt that they're playing for the line at the moment. As I say, it's just going to be a question of whether they have the quality to be able to take advantage of the breeze in the last quarter. As I said, we're going to find out fairly shortly. The Eagles at three-quarter time here, 9-13 to 6-6. A quick summary from Andrew Taylor.
Yeah, well, that was a funny old quarter. It started off with a great pace, but I think South, after the Eagles got a couple of goals and started to move away, really tried to bottle the game up. They did that very well. They created a lot less opportunities for the Eagles to kick goals.
So 16 points at quarter time, 16 at half time. The margin at three-quarter time is 25 points the difference on ABC Sport, 9-13 to 6-6. And South Adelaide, of course, last week, bouncing out of last week's game, which was so disappointing for them. They set a record last week of the lowest score ever at the Bay Oval. Stay with us. We'll see if they can improve on that in this last term.
Hi, I'm Debbie, and I love watching those firm football bodies running around the ovals on ABC Sport.
Now, the AFL have been playing around with some of the rules recently, the rucking rule, the holding the ball rule. They've played around with a lot of rules. Are they in the best interests of the game?
You'd be joking. They've absolutely crucified the game. Three umpires, I'll just mention that quickly because I know you're going to bring that up too. Why can't we go back to two? Well, you ask any umpire why we can't go back to two. They say, oh, no, we need them out there to make decisions. Every umpire that's ever been out there, all they want to do is make decisions. All footballers want is let the play flow on. The rule changes have been atrocious. Out there, especially ruckmen, let's get onto them first. Two ruckmen, strong, hair sticking out of them, snarly old blokes, wanting to bash each other. Let them go for the ball. Naturally, if they biff each other and in the head, you might better give a free here and there, but very rare because they're mongrels and they've got to be that way. It's silly. The philosophy of footy is to let people run hard at the ball. They're holding the ball now, sudden death. Lindsay Head'd love it, throwing the ball out in front. You know what Lindsay was like? He'd get a million free kicks today. He'd laugh at every time he got the ball nowadays. The umpires have got to know, David, and I've got to stress to them, if they listen, protect the man going for the ball. The man with his eyes, the ball, you do. But make it go that way. Let it be hard and strong. These do-gooders out there are trying to ruin our great game of footy, and that's the only worry I've got. The AFL, to me, is getting a bit bland, where the same thing happens all the time. Even though it's brilliant schools and they run all day, we've got to keep that hard stuff. Hey, you and me, we weren't as good as the Jezelenkos of this world, but at least in footy, and that's what I used to say, he might be better than me, but I'll go out there and give him hell, and you could do it. Now, little clip on the ear, free kick, you touch him behind, nothing that's stopping the play, and they free kick you, would you swear at them umpires today? And then you'd be off for another 10 weeks.
He's got his blood pressure up, hasn't he, Gary Windo? And when he gets excited, he's always good to listen to. Yes. But how do you see the umpires, Andrew? You've just come out of the game yourself. Are they paying the very soft ones, or are they letting it go enough?
I think I've been a bit critical of umpires over the years here since I've returned.
Are you a back chatter?
Yeah, well, I've said something to them, only to help them, of course. But the umpiring in general, the SANFL level, I think needs to come up a little bit. Now, I think they've got the rules that they've been given from the AFL people. They understand the rules, but their interpretation is the grey area. Now, a lot of times we have situations where players don't know what's happening. The umpires are calling it, as I said, I don't doubt that. But the problem in lies that their grey area is just too sparse.
I think, David, the general feeling amongst the SANFL fraternity is that the new umpiring director has a pretty level-headed approach about it, and we have seen some improvements in the umpiring this year.
Look, I'm not so sure necessarily there have been improvements. I don't think the umpiring director last year did a bad job. In fact, I thought generally it was pretty good. But there's been a lot of changes this year that the new umpiring director in Shane Harris has had to bring in. And I think generally it's regarded that he's brought them in pretty well. There is going to be a time, Andrew, when you won't see it so one-sided. But I think the umpires generally haven't been too bad. But there's been a lot of new interpretations that they've had to administer.
Bit of a cheap shot there on Andrew Taylor. One of the scorelines around town, Central are playing Glenelg, first playing sixth. And it's half-time. That game started a little later. I reckon it's a crunch game for Glenelg. They need to beat the top sides like Central and Port to give themselves a chance.
Certainly do, and they just cannot afford to drop too many, or they will fall away from that pack.
As I say, at half-time, that game, tomorrow's game at the Parade, the end of an era somewhat when, in suburban style, Norwood are playing Port Adelaide. And who's your tip in that game tomorrow?
I just tend to think Port need this win a little bit more. They like to set themselves up in this latter part of the year to give themselves a top two, top three finish. So I tend to think I'll go for Port out there.
Andrew Jarman back into the centre, of course. Be interesting to see how he goes. The North Adelaide and Sturt scoreline at Prospect Oval at three-quarter time. It's still competitive from the Double Blues, but dependent on what the Breeze is doing out there, they've really got some work ahead of them in the last term, facing that, 23-point deficit. Sanford has a couple, Phillips a couple, so too Tasker. And on the other side of the ledger, we're seeing it, Andrew, just too often from the Double Blues. Nobody who can kick five or six goals a game.
Yeah, they seem to have a deficiency with a tall up forward that can take a couple of marks and kick a couple of goals for them each week.
Would make a lot of difference to them, wouldn't it? But here at Noarlunga, speaking of having the work in front of them, South Adelaide went scoreless against the Breeze, just effect goalless, one behind only into the Breeze. The question now, David, is can they make the use of the Breeze at their back in the last term?
I think 25 points down is not significant in modern football. I think the Panthers are playing with more emotion and passion today, and I think they could, if they use the Breeze effectively and they get their big men marking and kicking truly, I think they still can get up.
There's the goal scorers. Neiman a couple, Ugrinic two, Morfitt two. On the left side of screen, again, a list of singles. Webb's been, well, he's been excellent, actually. Osborne's gone off the ground again. Lade has been worked and rotated through the ruck. Andrew Osborne, I said last week, over 300 possessions throughout the year, and sadly missed last week down at the Bay. He's just a great little worker, isn't he?
He's a quality player, and I think he actually gives a bit of oomph, if there's such a term, for the players around him. Yeah, he does. He Blake seemed to live off him and grow off him. And so the whole of the on-ballers seem to go very well, and they're going quite all right at the minute.
How do you see the last term yourself? The Eagles have to work into the Breeze. What would the tactics be now leading into this last term? Would they hold off or go hell for leather?
I think the style that the Eagles are trying to play now is a more attacking style. They try to get a bit more run out of their back line. So I tend to think what they'll try to do is zip it out of the centre early and try to get it up in the forward line as much as they can.
I should explain myself. When I mean that phrase, ease back or go hell for leather, really what I'm talking about is, do they go defensive or do they run it and use it and share it and still try and outscore the opposition into the Breeze?
I think you stick with your game plan that you know that it'll work, and the Eagles' game plan is to run the ball, not to bottle it up. The South, I think they're used to playing this windy conditions a bit more, so they're used to bottling it up, so stick with the game plan.
There's an important player on screen, Sam Philippo. If he sees a fair bit of the football in this term, they're going to be okay, the Eagles, and David Mackay will pick up this call in the last term.
25 points the margin in arrears for South Adelaide. Can they come back? They're playing good enough footy. The Eagles will need to work hard in this final term. Cobb, well marked at centre-half forward. It's paid in front of Rogers. Now, a goal here will just give them some passion for the contest. A long ball to Steckel. The big fella sets himself. Couldn't quite gather it in. This is Spear. Oh, he's muffed that kick out the back door. It's Pierce. Around the corner, McIntyre. Works hard for it. Browning missed it. Cleverly done, Baddams. But Neiman, who's rucking, playing a loose man in defence, you'd suspect two marks, and pushes it off to Rogers. Then Devine. Now Hall. Spear, who's played a corker today. High amongst the Eagles' best, that's for sure. Been a very solid game. McClure thumps it forward into space, but Colville gathers it in. Claimed by Genovese. And umpire Elliott indicates that he'll bounce.
So a bounce down on the far side. Get the feeling that if the Panthers are to do okay out of this, they really need the first couple of scores, such as this, the nature of their season. If the Eagles get the first couple, you'd expect that the incentive might just dip away fairly sharply for them. Conversely, if they get the first couple, they might see a bit of light at the end of the tunnel. Polkinghorne tries to sweep it forward. Zilla's been wonderful throughout the afternoon. To Christensen, forward it goes. Great looking drop punt into the Breeze. It holds up pretty well and gives an opportunity for the spoiled. Pesch off hands. He hands it over, and they mess around with it a little bit out there. Number 31 is Wietra. His kick goes right up towards the forward line. Oh, I thought the raking came across the shoulder. They play it on, and they work it out of defence.
This is Knight. Through the midfield, distributes it beautifully. Byrne. Now he's made a bit of an impact too, this youngster. Has one, goes long. Spear spoils away, did pretty well. Marty Christensen goes towards the safety of the line. I think that might be the Eagles' ploy this term too, by the way.
they'll just make sure that they don't give South an opportunity to kick a couple of quick ones and get back in the game.
Yeah, they don't want to go around just trying to save this game at the minute. They want to try to win it, so attacking football sort of wins you the game.
Boundary throw in, sees Neiman get a spoil into it. As they work it out, South Adelaide a half a chance. The long kick is a wide kick. And offline, through for one behind. In fact, it's out of bounds on the full.
That's the old problem too on a windy day. The higher you kick the ball in the air, the more the breeze is going to take effect on it. So a lower punch kick into the air, into the forward line is a better kick.
Mm. You've become a better player from up here, Andrew, don't you?
Oh, I certainly do.
Loose ball at the back. Well shepherded by Byrne. It allows Baddams to centre it up. Rogers will need to work hard for this one. Well, Webb was very committed and came crashing through. Took all before him. Now Osborne around the corner. Pushes it to the point of the square. Can Cameron get the loose ball? No, he can't, but he interferes with Pearce. And it's a free kick with little Adam Pearce deep in the back pocket for the Eagles.
I don't think Andrew Rogers was too keen there, was he?
Again, it's one of those ones you...
Select.
You may misread or whatever the case be.
Yes. Neiman spoiled away. Oh, McIntyre did it okay. Whitman's quick kick. Right up towards that front part of the goal square. They can't do much with it, or can they? Another shot at it. And another miss. It's almost an identical piece of movement from number 26 for South Adelaide there. Michael Johnston, he's missed.
Carlton defeated Adelaide by 67 points. We'll talk about the Andrew Jarman saga later. Collingwood defeated North Melbourne. What an upset that is. Now, Tony Shaw picked that by 61 points, and Hawthorne defeated Geelong by 2 points. You'd have to suspect that that was an upset, although Hawthorne have won, what, five in a row. They're looking pretty good, but Geelong are a great side. And Sydney, the juggernaut continues. The Swans defeated St Kilda by 17 points, and I'm sure the Sydney siders will be pleased about that.
The Panthers with another chance. Lade lays into it and misses by hitting the post.
You can see the Eagles have made that change we spoke about earlier today. Neiman has gone into the ruck and Bailey's gone to full forward. And in the last few weeks when that change has happened, the Eagles have slowed down a bit. So hopefully for them, it doesn't today.
Spear to bring the ball back into play by handing it to himself and then kicking long. Really gained some ground and got it out of the danger zone. South Adelaide bring it back into the centre corridor to give themselves a chance. Polkinghorne, they're working it around. They really need to score now and finish one of these off. Burns underneath the ball. Baddams, two versus one down here. Or will the boundary line win? Boundary umpire, I can tell you, was too far behind to tell. And the Eagles work it out of defence. A wobbly, wobbly old kick, but a perfectly weighted one.
All they really do need is someone who can take a mark down there at the minute. They've got the ball up, they've had the whole play this whole last quarter, and all they need is someone to get it in their hands.
Shane Butler, the South Adelaide coach, on screen with the moustache in the middle. He just seems to be very calm about this. He knows that the players have to play it out for themselves. High tackle against Zilla on Baddams.
That's what you need, a bit of attack on the football. Give yourself a chance.
Well, it's there, isn't it? It's there for the taking. Streaming out as David Steckel sets himself, the big man, two against one. It wasn't a fair contest, was it? Spear at the front, couldn't mark. Cameron off the ground, goes across the line. So they're pushing forward, South Adelaide, but they just can't get that one or two quick goals.
They've got all the play at the moment. They've got all the momentum. All they need is just get them one or two quick goals.
Steckel and Neiman, the two Goliaths. And a ball is pronounced dead. We'll have another bounce down. 9-13 to 6-7. Christensen gets up, hands it back. Not sure why the umpire is going to throw it up down there. Might be a little heavier than it looks from here. To Rogers. Handball's along the ground. Knight provides the pressure. Weech was there. The Eagles are there in numbers and they get it forward towards centre wing where Harris attacked the ball. Did it okay. Now, is this going to be the one? He's chipped short, didn't find the mark. He's put the player in McIntyre under all sorts of pressure. And his handball, conversely, was off the mark. Oh, they're just messing around with it at the moment. Can they find the target? Cameron was going to be it. You can hear the call through the commentary from some of their supporters. Come on, South. Well, I sort of share in that. Finish it off. I can't. The Eagles are going to find the boundary line. And if they don't, they'll go a little further away and still find the boundary line. But South Adelaide have closed it down.
There's a great credit here. The Eagle defence has been terrific. I know there's some frustration that South Adelaide's forwards haven't been able to finish off. But look at the great work, Andrew, by the Eagles defenders.
They have kept very tight to their players, as you'd expect. And they're very strong and try to run it out well.
Free kick in the ruck infringement. It's going against Eagle to David Neiman. Now, he's spent the entire game at full forward, the big fellow. Kick two goals, three. Now, in the final term, he comes into the ruck. And Bailey sits at full forward. So the 24-year-old has aspirations of an AFL career, and I suspect he might just be good enough and maturing like a good cheese. This is Laid, certainly good enough for AFL football, this young fellow. Filling out almost by the day. Not sure I like that blue mouth card. Looks like he's got a decay problem. But he'll kick deep into the forward zone. He's looking for a lead. Byrne goes off. That's ignored. Now, the big fella's 60 out with the breeze. He's back. I think he's going for a big tour. He fancies himself. Loose ball falls. Goes to ground. Out the back door, it's Byrne. Kick smothered. The Eagles' defence still working hard. Byrne again. Cameron handballs to himself, by the way. Now gives it away. Zilla forward. Pesh is good. Devine explodes from half back and goes towards Filippo, who dropped the chest mark. I think he was going before he actually had the ball. Now he picks it up. A long one through half forward. Who's the target underneath this? It's Colville. Nudged his opponent under it. Harrison gives him some pressure. Grubbers one forward. Bailey, he's not good in this area. Well, the ball's on the ground and he needs to work for it. He does struggle just a fraction.
His strength isn't on the ground, obviously, being playing as a tall. He's more of a marking type tap come ruckman. So on the ground, maybe he's not a strength.
Coming up a little later, the North Adelaide and Sturt match. And we'll have a couple of topics for discussion. There's plenty happened during this week as the Eagles go forward. They'll be cut off, though. Now, that's really their first entry, and that's pretty ordinary stuff back there by Duncan Draper. As a result, he's done nothing particularly good with the football, but Cameron was good enough to get out of trouble. This is what happens when you mess around with it. The first movement, the second, third and fourth is under some pressure. Bailey, a chance to really make them pay. He thumps it up there. They're in the box seat. But again, Draper sits back and takes a good mark.
Yeah, the Eagles need someone in the square at the moment. They don't have a tall player down there. So twice it's been bombed down and twice self's marked.
Whitman sets himself. Loose ball falls. Bailey recovers on the left boot. Goes towards goal. The breeze is grabbing it. Across to the left. In fact, it hasn't even been a score in the finish. It was out of play. Andrew, we might get you during this final term to think about your best players. You're fresh from the game. You I think are aware of the one percenters, the things that go unnoticed by a lot of other people. We might talk to you about those. As Bailey from behind pushes it down. Crashing through. McClure couldn't get clear. Well, look at the pack of players. There's some real desperation out there. Weitra applies a tackle on Cameron. But umpire Darrell Ryan indicates that he'll have a bounce.
Nine 13 to 6 7. Time is just ticking away for the Panthers. They need a couple of quick ones. And the Eagles are just finding their feet in terms of blocking things and slowing them down.
It's unattractive footy, all these packs, where the umpire has to come and ball it up. But it is hard footy. You usually end up pretty sore at the end of the game from this.
This is where the coach just asks you to tough it out. Make sure that nobody gets easy kicks or easy goals. Browning, loose ball, forward, snap. Draper sits back underneath it, just got a hand to it. Well, he left Bailey, and it's paid a dividend because he just got a hand to it.
There's a third time where he's been involved in the ball coming into the square, and this time he stops a goal, which he's done pretty well in this last quarter.
Well, the whistle's gone, and the South Adelaide player who kicked the ball in is going to be pinged for kicking it outside of the square, like Harris. And he won't be very happy about that. Number six on screen. Been around for a while, Brenton Harris, for just 63 games.
We did have a stint in Melbourne, Triggy.
He did as well. Bailey took it out of the air. And another dead ball. He's got a few things to say, Harris. Going to make any difference at all, though, as Zilla sits underneath the football. Bailey. Boys should rush it through, I think, and get a point. They do.
Again, very tight, very hard. No one wants to give or take anything at the moment. There's a lot at stake, so players are bustling in at all those packs to try to hold the ball in.
So let's see what Harris can do this time. He won't run outside the line, that's for sure. He goes straight down the centre. Draper sits. Oh, he's dropped it. What a faux pas there. That's one of his rare mistakes today, Duncan Draper, by the way. Filippo just flicks the ball forward into space himself. The handball goes high over the top. Clever work, Jagrinic. Dumps it down to Zilla. A high ball. This is where the big fellow in Bailey likes it. Two hands to it. Couldn't bring it to ground. Weitra, McClure off the ground. Grabbers one towards the goals. But look at that ball. It just ran away. A big off break.
Videos. The football videos at the ABC shop. Or by calling 08 343 4601. You can find yourself any of the SANFL games throughout this year. Knight is in there. Well, I think you're right, Andrew, when you say that the game's become a little unattractive as the Eagles close it down. And speaking of the Eagles, getting ready to come on is Marty Dillon for his first run at the 13-minute mark of this last quarter. Belted towards the goals. Draper gets onto a spiral punt kick and it goes about 60 metres towards the far side. Spear and Steckel engaged in a foot race. Spear goes for the sanctuary of the line and has found it.
Yeah, there's Marty Dillon on screen coming back from a busted eardrum. He missed about the 3 weeks or so with it, had to have it operated on and fixed up, and now he's right as rain.
Does he talk about playing South Adelaide? Does he, what sort of feelings does he hold for the Panthers seeing their flight?
Kevin Colville coming off there has played a good serviceable game. I think he might have kicked one or two goals, and he's very dangerous live wire around the forward line. But Hardy, the first time, was quite nervous and apprehensive about playing his old side, which you always are. But he got over that and played quite well last time.
So a long ball in. Oh, Bailey, the big fly, couldn't bring it to ground. Gave away a free kick. He took Polkinghorne out of the contest as he came down. So John Polkinghorne handballs off to Brenton Harris. And a long ball to the outer side. McIntyre was the target. Nemeth playing the loose ruckman in defence. Steps in and marks. He read that beautifully. Been a pretty important quarter for Nemeth. Kicked a couple as a forward. Oh, Pesha's carrying a leg injury. That's clear. Now back to Nemeth. Finding plenty of the ball now in this final term. Towards centre forward. The big fly was Jagrinic. Couldn't bring it down. Didn't get near it in the finish. Harris chips one. A little 9-iron. Well weighted. And Johnston, who... played out of a forward pocket today, hasn't had much say in this game. Has missed, three opportunities to score. Adam Pearce couldn't bring it down. Knight steals it away through half 40s, 48, 8 and closing. Goes long towards the goals. It's coming back, but not far enough. And another important shot for goal missed by the Panthers.
Yeah, good build-up again, that. Came back from the half-back line with a couple of change of handball and a kick. Probably could have run in a couple of few 10 metres or so extra, but probably no voice.
9:15, play 6-8. We posed the question through the third term as to whether South Adelaide were good enough to be able to use the breeze and take advantage of it. With a four-goal deficit at three-quarter time to come rattling home, well, they just haven't been good enough so far. Take something out of the ordinary for them to pick up and smack through a couple. 24 scoring shots to 14. They've tried hard, but they've been really outpointed as Rogers kicks in short. The player gets thumped, but still takes the ball. Is Pesh by the look. I think he would have enjoyed that very much, Nicky Pesh. In and out of the Crows side this year. It's a difficult task. And he seems to have made the switch pretty well. They work it out up towards half forward. Nemeth was there, so too is Morfitt. His opposite number six is Harris, and between them they see it to the line once more.
It's interesting again when the game starts to get tough and needed, a lot of the experienced players who've played in grand finals step up and start to do the right thing.
16 and a half minutes into the final turn, the Eagles are just wasting seconds on the clock, making sure that South don't make a charge. Knight got one high, play on said the umpire, bringing it down. Whitman claimed by Zilla, goes to ground holding the ball. So Jason Zilla, Whitman's not too pleased, the advantage allowed to fly. Oh, it's a goal. Great work by the Eagles. Sam Filippo put it right through the middle, and that's exactly what the Eagles needed, and Filippo gets his second.
A great play by Jason Zilla there. Whitman running at him, didn't have much of an option. He really had to go and try to be a bit stronger than Jason, but Jason Zilla held his ground, got in the ground, the ball popped up, and Sam Filippo was lucky enough to get advantage and run in and kick a nice goal.
Sam Philippa, he's been struggling a little bit, but I think he's turned it around at training this week. His training's been really good, and for us to be a premiership, real premiership contender, Sam Philippa needs to fire up, and he's heading in that direction.
Back in the middle at Noarlunga. 17 and a half minutes have gone. That will hurt South Adelaide very badly. They attacked for the first 10 minutes. They're attacking again through Steckel. Long searching kick. And the radar is just not working for South Adelaide in this last term. They keep pushing it to the left for some reason. Through for a behind. 10-15. 6-9.
All their shots seem to be long shots, long-range shots from outside 50 at the minute.
With the breeze, you wouldn't suspect that they're too hard. Oh, well done, Cobb. Good mark. He's impressed in only his third game today. He's really given them an option. And replaced Nathan Sinclair, who hasn't been their worst player, but you look at South Adelaide and they've got something to offer the competition because they've got some very good quality players. Dylan, Mark, not paid. Play on, said the umpire. Zilla mops up nicely. Weitri gets a kick forward. Well done, Pays used his bulk. Pesh comes in to lend support. I don't think that Knight and Pays like what's going on out there. And Johnston off, coming on. Sean McGuinness for his first run of the afternoon.
McIntyre pushes it forward. He was looking at Osborne, but the reflex from Pesh was excellent. Got it to Christensen. Now to half forward and those lengthening shadows. Just needed to hand off, put Harris under some pressure. Still has Baddams in some space. And Matty takes off and picks out Andrew Rogers as though he had a blue jumper on. To Devine. Short pass. Andrew, I'll accept your point, by the way, that the Eagles have used the ball much better. Every time they've handled it, they've found a body, or most times anyway, when South Adelaide have, they've been in trouble as Morfitt pings away at them and misses.
Yeah, unfortunate finish there from Scott, but that was a great, great play of football. Rogers cut it off, they switched the ball out the other side, a couple of very nice kicks, and to Morfitt.
Harris to the outer side. Knight. McIntyre. Well, when this fellow's on song, he's a real match winner. 29 years of age. You hope for South Adelaide's sake he's got two or three more years left in him. He's been dogged by injury. It's been a tragedy the last couple of years. It really has robbed him of some of his prime time. Byrne around the corner. Weitra. Let's see what this fellow's got to show. Left footer towards Marty Christensen. And Marty Christensen's got a new nickname given to him by Andrew Rogers. They call him Crocodile Christensen. And there's Tommy Weitra off the bench.
Laid is number five. He gets the tap in front of Bailey. And the Eags work it forward little by little. They've done okay in the breeze. Went to the breeze. South Adelaide have gone scoreless, goalless, I should say, once again, as they did in the third quarter. This time, though, they have a fairly hefty breeze at their back. They just haven't utilised it. It's a better tackle from Osborne. And then swept up the ball to get it to Baddams. But the weight of numbers has just told against them. And Rogers gleefully accepts it and then runs towards half-back and puts the ball to half-forward with a good-looking drop punt. Pays at the back. Polkinghorne. McIntyre. Oh, sweeps it forward. Player knew he was under some pressure, so he just messed around with it. And Dylan sees them to the line. Central have had some of their margin whittled away by Glenelg. That game's about 30 minutes behind, so... Glenelg is still a chance, and also a little later, of course, at about 5-5 tonight, we'll have a look at North Adelaide and Sturt and see if the Double Blues can make up some ground there and keep a break on the Panthers, who are sitting at the foot of the table at the moment and don't look like improving it at the moment at the 21-minute mark of this last term.
Now, they're going to have to pull something out. They're going to have to win this game. They need to get this ball down quickly up to those forwards and take a grab.
Well, I'll have to do something that I haven't done all day, and that is string them together. That's plays and goals I'm talking about. They look tired. They don't have a lot of incentive. They can't make the five now. As Nick Pesch comes off for Colville. Four in screen is Greg Osborne. Weitra missed it. Here's a chance. Webb, right leg. Again, a little hurried. Steckel should take this and does.
Yeah, very good work there by Webb. He ran on that ball very well on his non-dominant leg. Just pops it up at the top of the square. Great strength here. Two players shoving. Stoll just takes a good mark.
Now David Steckel kicks for goal. He's made it pretty close, Big Sticks. Oh, and he's missed. So David Steckel has kicked 364 goals, but he wouldn't be very happy with that miss.
David Steckel, he's captain of the club, now leading goal kicker this year, and we'll need him to kick four or five goals to win the game against the Eagles.
It's interesting in hindsight, Shane, because Steckel's kicked a couple of behinds. You're right, though, Shane, he needed to kick four or five goals for them to have a chance.
Yeah, it's not really a forwards day out there today, though, with the breeze, and there's not too many real multiple scorers and not too many forwards that have stood up and taken a lot of marks.
Hall plays it to himself, and off he goes to the far side. One hand up only for Lade, and then rides them like a cowboy. 10-16 to 6-10, 26 pings at the goal. Effective shots, that is, to 16, so they've well blanketed the Panthers this afternoon. We came down to Noarlunga expecting plenty of rain and wind. We've got the wind, Andrew, but it hasn't rained yet.
Hasn't rained, there's been plenty of wind, and it's been plenty cold.
A bit colder out there. Andrew Taylor, our guest this afternoon, who recently retired, announced his retirement after a fabulous career with the Brisbane Footscray and, of course, the Eagles. Forward it goes. For the Panthers, one last crack at it for them. Baddams gets on the end of it right on the 50-metre line. Now, I reckon it's beyond those little legs of his to get it right up there, at least through the goals, but he does get it up there, and it gets touched and hits the post.
He's been pretty impressive today, Baddams, I think. I reckon he's battled well all day. He's clean in the skills. He can also take a good grab. He's a player of the future, I believe.
Certainly one of their most consistent players, perhaps with Osborne, Andrew Osborne, throughout the year. As Spear has a look, decides not to give it to himself this time. Instead, Rogers just sat on the boundary line, and they try and set something up. Finally they do. The Panthers are losing feet. That was Baddams. Getting it back is Pierce to Rogers. Oh, gee, marshals them up well, doesn't he? Wheatra, Dillon. He'd be enjoying this against his old club. Colville around the body, only as far as the back playing McIntyre. They work it out, little by little. Fernie with a kick up towards the front end, and a free kick. Who's going to get it? Someone in a blue jumper. Well, they're all blue, just various shades. The one who's going to get it's got some green and gold in it as well. Shane Butler. It's an awful business, Shane, isn't it, when you're losing like this? Really looking down the barrel at the moment. But it is a tough, tough call for him. He took over a side after round seven that was struggling. And not having had them for a pre-season is really asking a lot. That's a good mark taken down there by Jason Ziller. Did okay for a little man in terms of playing tall. His short pass looks for and finds Ugrinic, who is an exciting player.
Yeah, well, this is Nigel Browning on screen.
Thank you, Andrew.
I'm just helping you out, mate.
Who's a good player as well.
Yes.
Who's this?
This is Ugrinic.
Thank
now,
you.
Ugrinic kicks on goal.
And what's he done?
Let's have a look.
I think he's kicked it. They like it, don't they? He has kicked it, Adam Ugrinic, or David Ugrinic. And that might be just about it at the 26-minute mark, because as he kicks through, truly, it's 11 goals on the board, 11-16 to 6-11.
Yeah, very good goal in the end there. The great mark by Jason Ziller over here, he actually is deceptively a good mark for a bloke that's quite short. And a good finish off with a goal by David Ugrinic.
And his third.
Ugrinic, geez, he's quick. He can run, he can jump, he can do everything. I'm sure Geelong are going to have a good look at him next year. He just runs and runs and runs all day, and they won't see him out there. He'll just be gone before they even look.
Yes, he has got great pace. South Adelaide a chance now. Push it forward. There's some tired lads out there now. There was Rogers again. Around the body from Lade. We saw him produce something miraculous early with the left leg in the square, and he's kicked his second. He's battled pretty hard.
He has battled quite hard. He's one of the combination of the three with Stoffel as well. And they're both, McIntyre, have all worked pretty hard to get hold of the ball. They've worked very well on the ground. And, you know, that's two very good goals he's got from picking up off the ground and snapping.
Come on, Eagle!
Fairly agile for a big man.
Come on,
Eagle! Brenton Lade, big 6'6" ruckman. If he gets his hand to the ball, you know, we'll go a long way to winning the game.
Those comments, of course, made by Shane before the game, and he'd be really disappointed with the way that they've not been able to make an impact. They have worked hard, but they're just, well, let's be honest, they're a bit understocked, aren't they?
They are a bit. They've got a bit to work with, though. They have got those three tours that we've spoken about quite a bit, but they've got a good fleet of foot running players that can possibly turn into a good following division.
Tackle in the middle of the ground, and we'll have another bounce down. 11-16, playing 7-11. It's probably, well, I would think just a bit late for all that. Umpire laying the law down, just as the siren goes. So that's it. The Eagles have travelled south to Wollunga Oval, and they're going to take home the points. They've won by 29 points, and they've done it in fine style.
Yeah, well, it was a very good win for the Eagles. Another one that's four in a row. They one that helps out their season a lot. They had to work hard to win it, though. The South were pretty persistent all day. From last week's performance, I guess South would have to take that as a step forward. They did very well in the way they contested the ball, but the Eagles probably just had a few better players on the day that played. That slight better polished game to win them the game.
Well, as you said throughout the call, I think one of the key things, Andrew, was that they found the mark more consistently with their hand and foot.
Very much so. I think that's an area where Self can work on, is just from getting the ball A to B, either by foot or by hand, to make sure that the ball gets where they want it to get.
So just a quick score check at the end of it. 11-16 to 7-11. Here's David.
Scotty Morfitt, a great win. Morfitt, four on the end now.
Yeah, it was a bit of a struggle there for a while. It's always hard coming down here, but we fought it out and we just got there, I think.
What was the preparation? Because their form was pretty ordinary in the last week or so, and you couldn't have taken them lightly today. What did you do during the week?
No, we were very worried. We'd had three on the trot, and coming down here, we were a bit worried about form droppage, but we just sort of got the mind right and concentrated on the basics, and we got away with it.
You got ahead 25 points at three-quarter time. You were never going to lose it from there. The tactics clearly were just to shut it out in the final term.
Yeah, just get in front and hold it and just get away with the points and get home. And
I thought your back line today was terrific. Jason Spear was outstanding.
Oh, look, they've been good all year. The support lines have let them down, but we're working on it.
We have knocked over Port Glenelg and North. Next week, you've got Norwood. After that, Sturton Central. You've got two big games in the next 3 weeks.
Yeah, we're trying to get up in the top three, but at the moment, we're just trying to stabilise ourselves, so hopefully we can come up with some good wins.
Now, we talked about your form, Morph. You kicked a couple today, but you didn't dominate the game. It's nice when you can still get a couple when you're not playing too well.
Yeah, I'm in the older bracket now, and if I get a couple, I'm pretty happy with that.
Now, tell us, just before you go, Andrew Taylor's in the commentary box with us today. Is he going to be missed by the club?
Oh, look, his camaraderie and his personality around the club will surely be missed, but you watch, to be a youngster come up, it'll take his role.
Well, the form's pretty good. The tackling's great. You look like you're back to 93 form.
We hope so, David. We really hope so.
Good on you, Morph. Thanks again.
Top star!
David Mackay downstairs with a very happy Scott Morfitt. I'm not sure that it's quite the 1993 form, although they are travelling a little better of late with four on the trot. They extended their lead throughout the day. It was 16 points at quarter time, 16 at half time, then 25 and then 29. So just graft out a win.
Yeah, it wasn't an all inspiring win, but it was a win nevertheless.
A couple of your best players very quickly?
For the Eagles, I must say I thought Andrew Rogers was pretty steady again all day. I thought Jason Spear's first three quarters especially was fantastic. Jason Ziller was very strong and good at it all day. So they were the main ones for the Eagles. Switching over to South, I thought Gary Cameron was quite good again. I thought Big Lade was quite
excellent,
good.
Excellent, wasn't
he? And Whitman in the centre, I thought, really set him up most all day, to the point that the Eagles had to try to tag him out.
But just not quite enough for South Adelaide. Thank you for your time throughout the afternoon. We look forward to catching up with you throughout the year. Enjoy your retirement.
I certainly will.